this concludes my presentation. Thank you very much. Any questions? They might send me home if I do that. That's not Guam, that's Visayas Sea. Yeah, can you hear me out there? Yeah. Thank you very much, Dr. Underwood. I have been introduced many times with yours. It's a very generous introduction. This morning I was in Greece. But that is the second best introduction I have ever received. The best one was last year when I spoke in a university in the Philippines where they published my name and my picture in the newspaper. And I was very flattered until I saw the page that it was on. Well, at least they expressed the sympathy for me. I am going to tell you a series of stories, in fact. One is the story of this man, I'll show you shortly. Then I will tell you the story of the Philippines. I will not, in fact, talk about the Visayas Sea too much, just as an example. I will be talking something more basic. You know him, sir? Yeah, handsome guy. That is how it looks like when he was older. Yeah, you probably don't know him because he was my grandfather. at the age of 82, he died and he left a will. His lawyer called me and said, you know, your grandfather liked you very much, loved you very much. He left you a will, which is now the equivalent of, with an inheritance, equivalent of about $10 million. Today's money. So I was very happy I deposited it in the bank. But the injunction was that I would only spend the interest but not the capital. So but I deposited the bank, I withdrew $1 million the next the day after. I invited all my friends, squandered it in the casino. And then the day after I withdrew another million, the day after I withdrew another million, and then 9.5 days later, there was only 500,000 left. Yeah. So what he accumulated, he saved up in the matter of 82 years. I squandered in the matter of less than 10 days. But that is not fine enough. What was even worse was that I go back to my accounting books and I tell my accountant to record all my losses and all my expenses as income, as profit. Is that correct? Who's an economist here? I see you shaking your hand, shaking your head. Of course it is not correct. But my friends, is that not what we have been doing to the earth? The earth has taken 4.5 billion years to become what it is. It is composed of the delicate mixture of the elements of life, land, air, and water. Man has been around for about 100,000 years or so, the Homo sapiens sapiens species. Life, they say, for 300, about 600 million years. Human civilization, about 7,000, 10,000 years old. And then, industrial revolution happened 200 years ago, barely. That started the era when we, that marked the era when we started using the natural resources faster than the resources of the planet itself. When we started using the capital instead of using the interest. So, by the way, what is the environment? Let's see. Somebody here is in charge of the environment or the Marianas. Anyway, this is a quick question. Where is the microphone? You know, I teach in the University of the Philippines, Cali, no, and we have recitation periods. So this is going to be a recitation, if you think. And then the president is going to create you. So, what is the environment? Okay. I will not require you to stand up. In my last week, you stand up. Natural resource. You see, in Filipino, I don't know if it's Chamorro, the word environment is not agriculture. In the Philippines, we call it kalikasan, nature. The problem with the word environment is that it does not sink in too much into the heart. Difficult enough to, you know, think of it as the surrounding. Well, it is not the surrounding. It is not about the birds and the bees and the flowers and the trees. That is why people like us, Mom, do you drink water? Yeah? Do you eat food, sir?
Of course.
Do you agree?
Of course.
Then all of us are invited to this. It is not about the birds and the bees and the flowers and the trees, but it is about life and resources of life, of land, air, and water. If you want a little, the acronym is easy to remember, and mnemonically, LPW. Where the trees in the forest are the heart and the lungs of the earth. We breathe because there are trees. They exhale oxygen. Where the land and the soil is the skin and the flesh of the earth from whence we get our food. And the sea and the waterways are the blood and blood streams of life. That is why, you know, the numbers even work out very nicely. 70% of the human body and 70% of the earth is made up of salty water. But applying that mindset of extraction, of using the capital, we cut down trees that have taken all natural history to form. We cut them down, and then we call them income, we call them revenue, we call them contribution to gross national product. Same thing with the fish, such that we've taken out 90%. And I'm not the one saying this, I'm, you know, usually a marine scientist. I just pick this up. And then we call it contribution to gross national product. We burn fossil fuels that took 100, 200 million years to form, burn them in our cars, in our fuel, burn them in our, to make electricity, and then we call it progress. Now we're facing the impact of climate change as a result of our excessive burning. Same thing with water. We use it up, and then that which we cannot use, we throw it away, and then we even dirty the remaining fresh waters. And then we call it progress. Look at that. This is a, maybe you're right. What do we Filipinos have to say about the environment? That is what we did to our sea. That is what we did to our rivers. Instead of fishing for fish, we're fishing garbage. I have a little sketch for you. I have a little name here. Which is more valuable? This one? Or this piece of 1 carat gold? Out 20 carat gold and 1 carat diamond. The water, it is more valuable, of course. It's a no-brainer. But what is more expensive? This 1 carat diamond or this water? Which is more expensive? This one. That's called the paradox of diamond and water. Things that are useless as far as life is concerned, we value and put at a higher price than things which are valuable, are so valuable to life. Britain, the United States, are they developed economies? Sir, I see you are from the Philippines. Britain, Japan, etc., are they developed economies? That's why we copy their paradigm of development. We like to have cars, we like to have all these things that are marked for development. Their development is based on consumption patterns. Consumption, the synonym of consumption, those of you who like English language, is waste. Another synonym, of course, is tuberculosis. We call them highly, they are actually highly consuming economies. They consume a lot of energy, a lot of water. Some of my best friends are from the United States. And 5%, 4.5% of the human population consumes 30% of the world's resources. That's percentage is not far enough. But what is even worse is that the whole world is trying to copy that lifestyle. And that has become our model of development. Such that if